Why do we pray? Why does the Holy Spirit come to us? Why are we asked to be more spiritual? Why do we need to draw closer to God? We draw closer to God so that God might reveal himself, and in revealing himself, he will reveal to us who we are. My brothers and sisters, the scripture says we are God's children now. We have been purchased and ransomed at a great price. We belong to God. And God has put the timelessness into our hearts. God has put a great longing and hunger and thirst for righteousness inside of us, that only God can satisfy our aching need and our aching heart. We want to know who we are, and we want to know to whom do we belong to, because it is there that we're able to ask for what we need and to receive it, so that we can continue to be more fully who we were created and meant to be. In that first reading, we get a sense that we need help. We need others. We need light. We need someone to carve the way for us. And that's what the Holy Spirit does. He infuses himself into the hearts of people to be like Mary and Joseph to us in this world, to be like the apostles, to be like the saints and the martyrs for us. The Holy Spirit takes residency in these loved ones, and he infuses their soul to the point that they want to do all that the Holy Spirit asks them to do. And this consoles them. It fills them. It encourages them. It makes them bright. It makes them light. It makes them more and more like Jesus, more and more like Mary, more and more like Joseph. The Holy Spirit is forming our hearts and conforming ourselves to him by allowing us to become more and more Christian, that is, more and more Christ-like. But we have to be able to allow the Holy Spirit to use others to draw us closer to him, because we're unable to do so on our own. The Holy Spirit gives us spiritual guides, spiritual fathers, spiritual mothers. He gives us spiritual directors. He gives us spiritual counselors. He gives us people where he has infused, because they cooperate with his grace, and then he uses them to lead others to Christ. That is who we are. We are to become light bearers. We have received the light of Christ. We are to take that in this darkened world and lead others to him by the way that we talk and move and breathe and live. St. Paul is encouraging his community. He's a great spiritual father. He's a great consoler. He's a great spiritual director. He's a great religious man, a holy man, a holy priest, a holy saint. He gives encouragement to his whole community, whether they're afflicted, whether they're in sin, whether they're stressed out, whether they're sick. He gives words of comfort through what he experiences in his own affliction and illness and hardships and trials and tribulations. He allows the Holy Spirit to use everything as a moment of grace, as a moment of light. He becomes one who encourages. He gives hope. He draws others to Christ so that they may taste and see the goodness of the Lord. For us, we are to be Christ bearers. We are to be light in this world. We are to be the ones who encourages our family to faith, to trust, to hope, to believe. That we are to be those spiritual fathers and mothers. We are to be the spiritual counselors and directors. We are the ones who are supposed to be the spiritual guides for others, that leading others to Christ, to taste and see his goodness. That's why Jesus leads us to the Beatitudes, because it is how he lived. And if we want to be more and more like Christ and be light bearers, then we need to be meek and humble. The moments of affliction and grief and mourning, rather than to turn to grief, we turn to hope. Rather than be discouragers, we are encouragers. We encourage people in time of need. Are you one who discourages others? Are you one of those who can never find a kind word? Are you one who does not give hope, but makes people feel hopeless? That's not from God, and that's not from the Holy Spirit. That doesn't lead people to God. That draws people away. We are, as St. Paul says, in our own affliction, in our own experiences, always to give a kind word, a compassionate word, a word of hope, a word of encouragement, because that's what Jesus has done for you and for me. Never to allow darkness to take over us or to allow us to despair. Never. Hope never disappoints. So there's always room for a word of encouragement.